A hexagonal prism of base 30 mm and axis 60 mm rests on its base on HP, with its axis perpendicular to HP and one of the base edge parallel to VP. The solid is cut by a plane which is perpendicular to VP, inclined at 40 degree to HP and bisecting the axis of the prism. Draw the front view, sectional top view and true shape of the section. For this, first draw XY line. Now we will draw top view first, because in top view you will get true shape of its base, that is hexagon. So draw a hexagon with one side parallel to XY line, because one base edge is parallel to VP. Now mark all these corner points, base corner points as A, B, C, D, E, F and top base corner point as G, H, I, J, K, L. Now project all this in front view. Height of this is given 60 mm, so take this height as 60 mm, close this and mark all these points. So this is A and this is F. F is visible, and behind F B point is there, so B point I have not shown here. Similarly, behind E C is there, behind E C is there, behind K I point is there, similarly behind L H point is there, which I have not shown here. Axis of this hexagonal prism, which is of height 60 mm, from the center you draw this line. Since section plane is perpendicular to VP, it will appear as a line in front view. Now this section plane is inclined at 40 degree to HP and bisecting the axis. So take middle point of this axis, and from this middle point draw a line at an angle of 40 degree, which is representing section plane. Now this section plane is cutting these different edges that are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 edges are there. So it is cutting these 6 edges at different points. Mark these points. So first 1 dash, 1 dash is the point which section plane is cutting edge AG. So at 2 dash it is cutting LF. This edge is cut by the section plane at point 3 dash. Similarly DJ 4 dash. Now IC, CI, this edge is there, which overlapping with EK, so it will appear at same position. So I mark this point as 5 dash, and then 6 dash, which is section of HB. So in this way, you have marked all the points where this section plane is cutting all the 6 edges. Now project all these points in top view. So you can see that all complete, this entire portion is cut and removed. So you can mark this, you can shift all this. So 1 is coming at this position, same, 2 at this edge, 2F at same position, 2F you are getting, similarly 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now this entire part is cut, therefore you have to show section. This is the sectional top view. Now to get true shape of the section, you have to project this section in a plane which is parallel to the section plane. For that, you have to draw a XY line which is parallel to this section plane, and then project all these section points. Instead of drawing this XY line again, I am taking one line which is parallel to XY line and joining 1 to 4. So I am drawing this line 1, 4, which is parallel to this section plane. And in this line only you will get 1 and 4. So project 1 and 4, that is draw lines from 1 dash, 2 dash, 6 dash, 3 dash, 5 dash and 4 dash. Draw lines perpendicular to this section line. So one, I have drawn line from 1 dash, so this point is 1. Similarly, draw all other lines, and 4 is coming in this point, this line only, so 4 also you got. Now 3 and 5 will appear in this line at same distance. So measure from here, from this point to this point, measure this distance and mark the point 5 here. And since it is symmetrical, so this distance of 3 from this also same. Keeping your compass at this point, you can cut both points with taking same length. So in this way you will get 5 and 3, and similarly you can get 6 and 2, which will be at same distance from this line, mark point 2 and 6. In this way you got all the points. Now join all these points using thick lines. Now this is a true shape of section. now hatching line. You provide this hatching line, and in front view all the visible lines should be drawn thick. So I have drawn this thick line, and this is the required front view, top view, sectional top view and true shape of the section. Thank you.